proactively ensuring that your device endpoints stay up and running while remaining policy compliant is only possible with access to current device-level data and analytics. Today, I'll show you how data-driven device decisions are now possible across device platforms with the cloud-based endpoint management platform, Microsoft Intune, and its advanced analytics that help inform the actions you take, enabling advanced management for iOS, Android, macOS, and Windows devices, along with AI-powered options to discover and resolve issues using Microsoft Security Copilot and new agents with Intune. Of course, the primary goal of device management is to eliminate downtime while maintaining secure access to the resources people need on their managed computers and phones. If done right, this should also lead to fewer support calls. Intune now makes it easy to query granular information about your cross-platform devices to find data-derived insights. In fact, with Intune, you have the data you need at multiple levels to manage your devices. It starts with advanced analytics to get proactive insights across your endpoints. Multi-device query then lets you query across platforms on demand, and single-device query shows you real-time information for running processes, drivers, and more per device. Let me show you how it all works together, starting with advanced analytics. I'll start with tenant-level reports under endpoint analytics. Here you can see the health status of all my managed devices. In my case, everything looks pretty good. That said, there are a few opportunities to improve startup performance. And on the right, I see insights and recommendations that I can address immediately. For example, these two here are showing above average CPU and RAM spike times. And if I dig into this recommendation, I can see that these three devices on top have a low score under 50 for CPU spike time, and this one also has a bad RAM spike time score. Now, if I take a look at the CPU and RAM specs here in this column, these might be a little bit too low for this user. And I can drill into the specific device for more details on its user experience, and we can see it's consistently spiking over time. And I can use this information then to increase the cloud PC spec. This is a great example of getting ahead of issues with proactive analytics. And beyond that, I can also do on-demand analytics using multi-device query. And this goes beyond the single device querying that you may be used to with CMPivot. It allows you to query multiple devices across platforms from iOS and Android to macOS and Windows, and is great for querying thousands of devices based on their attributes. For example, let's say I want to update a policy for personally owned devices enrolled last year or earlier that are currently non-compliant. That's where multi-device query comes in. I'm at the all devices level in device query. And you can see there are cross-device options for several different property categories here. And by expanding the device property set, I can see a ton of options for devices. So here I'm going to type the query device, then I'll add a condition for enrolled date time using this where clause to find devices enrolled prior to this date. Now I'll type in another for personal device ownership and one more to find non-compliant devices. Let's go ahead and run it. And here I can see all of my results. You'll see that these span all OS platforms with macOS, Windows, Android, and iOS from a variety of manufacturers. Then if I scroll to the right, you can also see our enrolled date field. Then a bit over from there, we see the ownership and compliance info as queried as well. Multi-device query uses information that refreshes daily for online managed devices. And importantly, if you aren't fluent yet in KQL, that's okay, because using Copilot and Intune can help you author both multi and single device queries. So I'll open up Query with Copilot. Then I'll prompt it with find personally owned devices enrolled last year or earlier that are non-compliant. And that will take a moment to process. And once it returns a response, I can see the results of the query. You'll see the date time syntax here is a little bit different than mine from before, but both work the same. From here, I can even run it. And it's outputted the same list of devices as before without me needing to know how to write KQL for it. That's multi-device query. Now for single devices, you can also query them individually using device query. And the big difference is that the information that you're querying is real time and there's more granularity available. So it's great for troubleshooting a single device. From the devices view, this time I'll navigate over to a single device, this one, Joba DQ. Then at the bottom under monitor, you'll see device query. So I'll open that. And as you can see, this looks quite a bit like the multi-device query that we just saw, and it uses the same KQL interface. What's great about our single device query is that you can also query all the currently running processes, and you have a lot more Windows-related options for drivers, events, querying the registry, services, and more. In my case, I'll just run process to enumerate what's running on this machine. And it returns all the running processes. And again, these are reporting back in real time, kind of like Task Manager or Process Monitor would do running locally on Windows, but it's right here in the Intune Admin Center. Next, let's move on to how data-driven management gets even more powerful when addressing security vulnerabilities. For this, I'm going to use the new Vulnerability Remediation Agent with Copilot and Intune. But instead of starting in Intune, I'll start in Microsoft Defender. But don't worry, if you're not the person who typically uses Defender, that's okay. I'm going to show you why in a minute. So I'm in Exposure Management and Recommendations and in the Vulnerabilities view for devices. And in the Security Recommendations list at the bottom here, I can see a few actions that my device management team would need to take. Now this one here for the Relic Cloud Sync client looks like it needs an update. The impact is high, and there are quite a few exposed devices here, and some of them are critical. Now, if I click into it, I can see even more details. And if I move over to the Exposed Devices tab, the three on top are critical. Moving to the Associated CVEs tab, I can see there are 49 known vulnerabilities associated with this app. As you can see, it's pretty important that we deploy this update. So how does this visibility then translate into the Intune Admin Center that I can use for endpoint management? Well, that's where the new Vulnerability Remediation Agent comes in. I can access it from Intune's home screen, and that takes me to the Endpoint Security Blade in the Agent Overview tab. Now, I've already deployed this agent to run daily and look for vulnerabilities and prioritize them for remediation. It looks like there's a run in progress that was just kicked off. Now, the agent run takes a few minutes to process all the vulnerabilities and also find matching impacted devices. Once the run is complete, I can see its suggestions. And you'll see that the top suggestion matches what we saw earlier in Microsoft Defender. So I'll review it for additional details about its evaluation. Now on top, there is a suggested action. Again, this is consistent with what we saw in Defender before, except now I can actually do something about it myself and deploy the fix right from Intune. That also means that any action that the agent recommends also requires the approval from an Intune admin. This is the first of its kind agent for Intune with more on the way. And for more data-driven management, Copilot and Intune with its capabilities across the admin center can save you time with other common daily tasks. Beyond what I showed earlier where it helped me author KQL queries, Copilot also gives you the information needed to manage and troubleshoot your configuration policies and devices. First in policies, you can use Copilot to assess the impact of a policy and the settings that are contained within it. And for individual settings, Copilot can tell you what each one does with a lot of detail. It can analyze individual devices and identify potential issues based on what's configured and running on each device. And in the prompt guide menu, I can find even more options to use with Copilot. In fact, one of my favorite capabilities is when I have two similar devices, but only one has an issue. In this case, Copilot can compare each device configuration and figure out the differences between them to help you isolate potential issues. Copilot also gives you general help when looking up error codes to understand them. Additionally, for endpoint security, you can use Copilot with endpoint privilege management to identify potential app risks and get the details about why an app might be compromised. And for your Surface devices from the Surface Management portal, Copilot can be used to quickly generate device insights. So that's how integrated device and security data in Microsoft Intune helps you make informed, data-driven decisions to keep your devices running, secure, and compliant with the policies you set. To find out more, check out aka.ms/copilot-intune and aka.ms/device-query-intune to see what else it can do. Keep watching Microsoft Mechanics for the latest updates from Microsoft, and we'll see you soon.